Okay, so now we look at interfacing. Interfacing, see, either you can interface memory, or we can interface any peripheral devices, that is I/O devices. So we can do I/O interfacing. So memory, as we know that address of any memory location is going to be 16 bit. This memory interfacing is going to take up 16 bits. This is 16 bit interfacing, and this I/O interfacing is 8 bits. Any input output devices that we are going to connect to a microprocessor are going to have 8 bit addresses. So first we are going to look at memory interfacing, then we look at I/O interfacing. So see, already we have seen that. Okay, let us just quickly recap. Suppose this is a microprocessor and this is a memory. So we had 16 address lines in which higher order address bus A15 to A8 is connected directly to the memory, and then there is a multiplex bus. For right now, what I am doing is I am just representing the address line separately, and suppose these are the data lines, okay, they are also connected to the microprocessor. Fine, then there is going to be one more active low signal, which is chip select, CS bar. This is chip select. This is to, suppose you have interfaced 2-3 RAMs, then whichever RAM is having this chip select as low, that RAM will be selected, that memory will be selected. So this is the memory. Now all of us know that since there are 16 address lines, each memory location is going to have a 16 bit long address. We've talked about this earlier also, we just taking it once again. Every memory location has a 16 bit address, so addressable memory, total number of memory locations present is going to be 2 to the power 16. Also each memory location is going to hold 8 bits of data, so this becomes a total of memory sizes 2 to the power 16 into 8, which is 64 KB. 2 to the power 10 is known as 1 kilo, 2 to the power 20 is 1 mega. Okay, so addressable memory of a microprocessor is going to be 64 KB. Also starting address of the memory, least possible 16 bit address of the memory is going to be 0000H, and till the last address of the memory is going to be FFFFH. Fine. This is going to be the address range of the memory. Now see, one more possibility can be, suppose I am putting here a AND gate, and what I do is three of the address lines I am giving through this one, okay, three address line A15, A14 and A13, A12 to A8 are given as usual. So see what happens here is, suppose this is a NAND gate, okay, put a NAND gate here and I'll put a bubble here. Fine, so what happens is, through this NAND gate, what happens that these three lines have to be one all the time. They have to be permanently one, because if they are not one, this chip is not going to be selected. So what happens with the address ranges? These three bits are fixed, they need to be one. Fine, whereas other bits can be all zeros or all ones. So the address range becomes, see, this 1110 is E. So the least possible address is E 000 to F address range changes because we are using only, we're not using 16 address lines now, we're using only 13 address lines, and the other three lines have been permanently connected, have to be permanently connected to high, connected to one. So these three lines are permanently one for this chip to be selected. So this, these are fixed, they are fixed at one. Other bits can change. So this is how you can interface a memory. You can interface a memory of required address range or of required address lines. So now we're just going to look at a question. So suppose we are given a question, interface a 1 KB memory with address range 1 KB memory. Okay, so this is a given question. Now just look at the size of memory first. 1 KB. 1 KB is 2 to the power 10 into 8 bits, which implies, see, data lines are going to be 8 only, right? So these 8 are going to be the data lines. Data lines for this memory are 8. And how many address lines are available? We are having 10 address lines. 10 address lines are available. That means you can have a 10 bit long address for each memory location. Now what do we do with the 666 remaining address lines? Just see. So see, also they have given one more thing, that the starting address should be 1000. To make starting address 1000, what do we do is, just fix the, we need only 10 address lines to make this memory. Only 10 address lines are required. We have 6 extra address lines. What do we do with them is, we fit them in a circuit so that they can be used for chip select. Okay, we fix their values. How do we fix their values? Using the given address range. So 6 extra address lines are going to be A15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. These are the 6 extra address lines. What do I put their values as? What is the starting address? 0001. That is how you write 1 hexadecimal, 00, right? And what is the, for starting this address, all these bits are going to be 0. These 10 bits can change, these 6 bits are going to be fixed. Now for the ending address, these are going to be fixed values, right? These are going to be fixed, these 6 bits cannot change. These can change though. So clearly see, starting address is 1000, and this address, ending address is 13FF. Okay, so this is how we can create this memory. Now suppose I ask you to draw a diagram representing the interfacing. So what do we do? Again, we are going to use a NAND gate, which we are using for chip select. Okay, I told you about a chip select signal, which is active low signal. So this is the memory, suppose, and this is your microprocessor. So what do you do with the higher order address lines? I'm just putting them here. Just putting a NAND gate here. Now see, A15 needs to be 0. So I'm putting a bubble here. A14 also 0. A13 also 0. A12 has to be 1, so I'm connecting it directly. A11 0. 8, 10 also 0. Right? And what do we do with the remaining of address lines? Okay, rest of the circuitry remains same. Rest of the circuitry is going to remain the same. Just these 6 address lines we are going to connect like this, okay, using a NAND gate. We are going to connect them and use them for this chip select. What happens when we do this is, we were required, see, we had only a 1KB memory. 1KB memory means the only all the memory locations are going to have 10 bit long addresses. If they are having 10 bit long addresses, that means only 10 address lines were required. But we were having 16 address lines, so we had to adjust them, we had to place them in such a way that 10 lines can be used for addressing the memory, but the other 6 lines had to be adjusted. So we use them in a way so that they can be used for chip select. How did we use them? We first saw the address range was given. We just found out the status of each and every line, each and every bit of this address line. We found that A15 needs to be 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. So we connected them to a NAND gate and connected this to a chip select signal. So the status of these bits are going to be fixed. They can change and accordingly we can select the memory location. Okay. Suppose we've got a question to interface a 2KB memory, interface a 2KB memory with address range from 3000 to 37FF. Okay, so this is a given question. What you can do is just try this question by your own first. Same method from which we did the previous question. Same method will apply to this question also. You can just try this on your own first, then you can just check the answer. See, firstly what we do is, we just check the memory size. Memory size is 2KB, which means 2 into 2 to the power 10 into 8. From where we know that these represents the data lines. They are going to be 8 data lines, right? This is number of bits, okay, fine. This is going to be 8 data lines. And we need 11 address lines. That is, the memory that has to be interfaced can only accommodate 11 address lines. But we know that the microprocessor that we are using has got 16 address lines. So what do? We have got 5 extra address lines. How do we accommodate them? We give them some values and fix those values and use those 5 extra lines in a way that they can be used as a chip select signal. So, okay, let us just see. See, we are always taking all the extra lines that are available, we are always taking them for higher order address lines, right? See, starting address that they have given is 3000. 3 can be written as 0011, then we have got 0. Okay. Then they are going to be all zeros for starting address. Last address, ending address is given as 37FFF. Okay, right. So we have got the status of the pins. We know that A15 has to be 0, this has to be 0110. So these 5 pins are fixed. The status of these 5 pins are fixed, although the other 11 pins can change. So what do? Same thing that we have already done, okay, we're just doing it again. Suppose this is your microprocessor. This has got 16 address lines, so what do? This is your memory. Okay, maybe. This is the memory, fine. We're using a NAND gate here, using a NAND gate for chip select. And what do? you connect here five address lines I'm connecting. Okay, fine. Now just check A15 has to be low, so putting a bubble here. A14 also low, A13 1, A12 1, A11 0, and now from the higher order address bus, 3 lines are remaining. Connect them as it is, A10, A9, A8. Okay, they can change their values. This is a chip select signal, and these are the remaining lines. Fine. Okay, so there are going to be read bar, write bar, all these are going to be present. Okay, we are not focusing on them right now. Right now we are just seeing how to interface the memory. Interface the memory means what is going to happen to the remaining address lines that this memory cannot accommodate. So this is what happens in interfacing a memory. Okay, so now we see that how can we construct a larger memory, a memory of bigger size using smaller chips, using memory or RAM of smaller sizes. Suppose we have got a problem. Construct a 1 KB memory using 256 cross 4 RAMs. So you have to construct a memory of bigger size using chips of smaller size. Now just see the capacity of this memory. This is going to be 2 to the power 10 into 8, whereas size of each RAM here is, see, 256 is 2 to the power 8 into 4. First we find out that how many chips are going to be needed, required, number of chips. This can be found out easily by, see, this is the size of required memory and that is the size of available memory. So I am just dividing size of required memory by size of available memory. That means I am going to require 8 chips of this size to make a memory of this size. Now see, one problem that we have got here is data lines in each chip, in each RAM is 4. 4 data lines are available, but I am trying to make a memory which has 8 data lines. So what I am going to do is I am going to combine each block, in each block I have to combine 2 RAMs, 2 chips, so that combinedly they have 8 data lines. How am I going to do this is, I am going to use a multiplexer. You heard of a multiplexer? I am going to use a multiplexer which can select which chip is required, which block of chips is required. I am going to make 4 blocks, each of 2 chips, so that I can have 8 data lines. And see, each chip has 8 address lines, but I require 10 address lines. So the extra 2 lines I'm going to use as input of the decoder to select. So what am I going to do? I'm using a 2 cross 4 decoder here. I'm giving 2 inputs to this decoder. If you get 2 inputs, you know that 2 cross 4 decoder, what it is going to do? You've got 4 options to select accordingly. Now what am I doing? In each of the blocks, I'm putting 2 chips. Since I required 8 data lines and each chip could provide 4. So I'm putting So what happens is, see, this chip has got its four data lines. This has got four data lines, and combinedly you get eight data lines. You required eight data lines from this memory, you are getting eight data lines. Okay, same happens for each block. Now each block was capable of having eight address lines were allowed. So A7 to A0 we are using as address lines of these chips. Okay, same for both the chips, because we want to use the two chips simultaneously, so we are giving same address lines. And what do we do with the higher order address lines, that is with A8 and A9? I am going to give them as inputs to this decoder, due to which what happens is, when these A8, A9 are going to be 00, this block is going to be selected, and according to A7 to A0 what address you are given, memory can be accessed. So this is how you are going to place the 8 chips to make a memory, 8 to 56 cross 4 RAMs to make a memory of size 1 KB. Fine, this is all about memory interfacing. Now we're just going to look at a few concepts of IO interfacing, peripheral interfacing.